We're now going to get the side of the private prosecution team in Palparan's case. We're now joined by Attorney Josalee Deinla. Attorney Josa is the spokesperson of the National Union of People's Lawyers. Attorney Deinla, good afternoon to you. Thanks for joining us today. Appreciate you coming to the show.
Yes, thank you for having me. Magandang tanghali sa iyo.
Okay.
Sa lahat ng nanonood sa.
So, first question, same question that I asked Undersecretary Marco there. What do you make of the interview that happened?
Yes, actually, we find that there's a lot to unpack from this incident, Carmina. Because we're seeing double standards in effect here, special treatment being accorded to General Palparan as a convicted felon committed at the MBP, and also the clear misuse of government time and government resources, no, through the NTF-ELCAC to valorize a known human rights violator and a convicted felon who has been proven to be so in a court of law and even the UN Human Rights Committee, and also to red tag his accusers, his victims, and their families, supporters, and their respective organizations. So the reverse of what is being done to activists and critics of the government is being done here, no? Whereas they are being red tagged, they are being dehumanized and unfairly labeled as communist terrorists. This convicted felon, General Palparan, human rights violator, is being glorified and even being heaped praises, no, by the NTF-ELCAC government body at that. So we condemn this incident in the strongest terms.
Atty. Deinla, as part of the private prosecution team against Palparan, what do you think, what message do you think this interview conveys to the public, to the families of the victims? What message does this convey about the government?
We see this as scoffing off impunity, Carmina. And we can only imagine the pain and suffering that the parents of Karen and Sherlyn were made to feel while viewing that interview. I myself could not even finish it. Hindi ko kaya. I cannot stomach it. No? For Yusek Badoy to be saying that they want to vindicate General Palparan for all his crimes, simply unconscionable and unacceptable.
So let's get into that. Let's get into that, Attorney Deinla. Since you mentioned it already, there was a part in that interview when she said that, right? The fact that it happened, that the fact that the interview happened is one thing. The reason being given for why it had to happen is another thing altogether. And you said exactly the reason for why it had to happen. According to Yusek Badoy, the program was done to vindicate Palparan. It was done so to sort of disabuse the minds of people, because to their minds, Palparan was convicted because of trumped up charges. How do you then react to that? What do you even say to that kind of a justification for the interview?
I would call it for what it is. What the NTF-ELCAC, through the spokesperson, did in that interview is to conduct this or make this hate speech against activists and critics of the government. No, she sought, through the NTF-ELCAC, to delegitimize certain political views, to discredit the causes and advocacies of our clients, to dehumanize them as the subjects of this vicious red tagging. And we know from abundant experience that red tagging has heralded the escalation of intimidation and the commission of violence on the persons being red tagged. Marami na tayong karanasan. And it also creates a chilling effect on speech and other freedoms that we are supposed to be enjoying in this society. Also diverts our attention and energy from pressing social issues. It is in fact a high impact strategy with very low cost to this government to silence criticism and dissent in the guise of counterterrorism, and also part siya ng arsenal niya ng weapons or toolkit, so to speak, to incite hatred towards activists because of their political beliefs.
And what do you make of the lack of control during that interview? I was just talking to Undersecretary Marco. He did say that with the requests from the network to the Bucor, in it should have been a list of topics that will be discussed. And at any given point, if the interviewer goes beyond the parameters, the Bucor can step in and stop the interview. Undersecretary Marco is, as we speak at the Bucor, he's going to look at those requests, look at those topics. But the controlling factor, obviously, wasn't there during the interview. In fact, there was one point where Palparan was spewing all these allegations against Senator Laila de Lima. And at one point even saying and admitting that this was hearsay on his part because it was just, you know, stories being said by his fellow inmates. What do you make of the freewheeling discussion that happened? And it went on for 2 hours, Attorney Deinla.
Yes, I mentioned earlier that this is an instance of impunity because Palparan has already been convicted and sentenced to imprisonment, which is an afflictive penalty. And his freedoms are no longer the same. He is no longer a free man. That's why when he wants to exercise his freedom of speech, he has to follow the regulations of the Bureau. And I would like to draw your attention to this particular provision in the Bureau of Corrections manual that there is a prerequisite to the approval of requests. The media representative or the news organization shall give the prison administration the opportunity to respond to comments made by the inmate in the interview, which clearly was not followed because it was live. So perhaps the Bucor, can we say now that the Bucor is adopting the views of Palparan? And we find it also curious that the DOJ was not informed, considering that this case, the kidnapping and serious illegal detention case where he was convicted, is a high-profile case for which the DOJ is taking pride in for good reason, because they effectively prosecuted this case and was able to secure a conviction against a human rights violator like Palparan. Mm. So,
there was a point in the interview, Attorney Deinla, when they talked about tagging, and it's not about red tagging. In fact, he claims during the interview that the communist rebels were actually the ones who first started to tag him as a criminal, as the butcher. Was it all made up? Was there, in fact, no proof or evidence that he indeed was responsible for the crimes he committed and is actually behind bars for?
Carmina, there is abundant proof of his criminal acts. That's why he was convicted in the first place. And even way back in 2008, the UN Human Rights Committee said that the Arroyo government is responsible for the extrajudicial killings and enforced disappearances, some of which were committed under the watch of Major Palparan. Wherever he went, he left a trail of blood, Carmina. And kasama dito yung pagpaslang doon sa human rights defender na si Eden Marceliana, peasant organizer na si Eddie Gumanoy, at marami pang iba. We have a lot of proof of his wrongdoings. So we cannot just claim, no, na propaganda lang, sabi lang, tagging lang ng mga sinasabi niyang CPP-NPA front organizations.
We know where Undersecretary Badoy stands, right? We know where the NTF-ELCAC stands. But for this to have happened, should this have happened still? I mean, how do you even justify, or is there any way to justify what we just all witnessed?
I see nothing, no, justifying or warranting everything that happened. Apparently, with the imprimatur of the Bureau of Corrections, and we are hoping that with the results of the investigation being conducted by the DOJ, a similar incident will no longer take place, and Palparan will no longer be given the special treatment that he is being given at the NBP. Carmina, we also received A1 reports that he is not committed at the maximum security where he should be. Nasa minimum security lang daw siya, and he is being given privileges that he should not be given as a maximum security felon. So maraming kailangan ayusin at i-correct na nakita natin dito sa pangyayari.
Are you going to leave it all up to the DOJ to conduct its investigation? Are you also going to hold your own investigation and discover what needs to be discovered here, why the interview even had even happened.
Yes, in fact, today we are sending a letter to the Bureau of Corrections to demand to know, no, what happened, ano talaga yung nagbigay daan dito sa interview na to, because we want to seek accountability and we want to put General Palparan in his place.
What are your expectations from the DOJ?
Well, in fairness, in all fairness, no, the DOJ secretary immediately commented that he has no knowledge and that he immediately required the investigation. In fact, the USEC is already there conducting a meeting, no, with the viewport to find out what happened. So, tingnan natin, no? Tingnan natin, Carmina, kung ano yung magiging resulta ng kanilang investigation.
We're going to have to leave it at that. Attorney Josalee Deinla, spokesperson of the NUPL, thank you so much for joining us today. Really appreciate you coming to the show. Take care and
Welcome.
Keep safe.